friendly Manitoba, right? The license plate holds true most of the time.
The help is unlimited and people come out of everywhere to give you a hand when it's needed.
Showing people that these small communities were alive, we're thriving, and we're doing well.
Southwestern Manitoba is built on farmers, oil field workers, laborers, and small towners. Many small towns are like big families, and when these families come together and work hard, they are able to put on a worthwhile show that most can enjoy. With Mud and Dust Flying, you will get a first-hand look at the potential small towns have to put on a good show. Sinclair Redneck Days takes place in a small town in the southwest corner of Manitoba. Sinclair is a small town that doesn't offer a lot, but around the end of June, it offers a good time and maybe some dirty clothes.
My name is Dick Irwin, and we're hosting Sinclair Redneck Days, and it's the Mud Bog part of the Redneck Days. So everybody had to come together to bring this to life. If we all butted heads, there's no way this would go off. It takes the food, the organization, the meetings, the after-hours stuff that nobody sees is immense, like in making this come off.
Came for the Mud Bog, raised some money for Sinclair Hall.
It was the fastest of all.
I think the second closest was 5.7 or 9.
I think you win a set of tires or something.
They figure whatever, I got a car sitting there, it's not costing me nothing.
This town is a very small town. It's a farming community, but we pull it off because the heart's there from everybody. And everybody that comes here knows their donation's going to the hall, community upgrades, and community maintenance, you know, everything goes back to it. We don't retain anything for ourselves, obviously, it's all volunteer. Yeah, I think that's what keeps everybody coming back.
About 40 minutes away, driving the speed limit, Melitta is having their annual Banana Days. There are lots of things to enjoy, but a large crowd is drawn toward engine roars and Bud Fly.
My name is Brooke Oliver, and I am the secretary, I guess, or treasurer of the Melitta Mud Bog. We have tons of people in the community who just show up to help with the canteen and building the track. And I guess that's the benefits of a small town. It's just like a big family coming together and everyone is connected to it in some way.
From the skate of Manitoba, and I'm just here making mud fly. This is just the cow chasers, all it is. I got fast cows.
It's always a competition between friends. You know, I can get further than you. No, you can't. I can get further than you. It's good to come out and support stuff like that.
One thing about a small town, there's not a huge amount of things to go to. So, you know, we used to have local fairs, we used to have cattle shows. Well, those have all died out, so you try to keep up with current times. Big cities, there's selections of everything. You can go for rides every day, whatever. Well, this small town thing, we try to do the best we can with what we've got.
Apple Festival, usually held at the end of August, is a great atmosphere for everyone, complete with concerts, dancing, and rides. There is also a mud bog hosted by Vic Weems, which is one of the larger mud bogs in Manitoba during the summer.
I got second last weekend and 2 weekends ago in Mileta. I don't know how I'll make out today, but I've been to Sinclair, Mileta, Morden. I've had a great time at them all. My kids get to stay out with their family, just do a family thing. I'm not here to win anything, just to get my truck dirty.
It's just like any young guy with a four-wheel drive truck who likes to go see what it'll do in the mud, you know. And this is just a little more controlled environment. Our track is 200 feet long. Our super stock, that is that you're allowed 3 engine mods. Pro stock is any engine, but a full-bodied truck. Modified, you can move your axles, we have cut tires. Any engine you want except no superchargers, turbos, or nitrous. And the open class is basically anything goes.
It's a little bit of community involvement. You get to see your cousin or your brother or your neighbor take their truck through a pit. You can sit in the stands and cheer them on and be part of it.
Toulon is host to an event that has been going on for years. The annual tractor pull brings in a large crowd for the town and puts on some old-fashioned entertainment, seeing which machine has the most muscle.
I'm Donald Duffner from Buxton, North Dakota, and this is an annual tractor pull that they've been having at Toulon for several years. I started in 1964, so I guess that would bring it up to about 49 years. Well, when it started, it used to be a sheet of iron, and every 10 feet a guy would step on and the tractor would grunt a little more, and you'd have a speed limit so you couldn't go more than 3.5-4 miles an hour, otherwise it was unsafe. So it was kind of fun then too, you know, when a big guy got on his skid, you could hear it on the tractor.
I think it's great to bring people to town and they get to see your town, those that aren't familiar with it. People come to Toulon because of the tractor pull. Everybody relates to the tractor pull at Toulon. It kind of gets your town on the map a little bit.
Demo Derby in Verdun is also an event that has been going on for many years and takes place during their annual rodeo. This town comes together and puts on one of the best derbies in Manitoba.
You feel at home, you're welcome, everybody helps everybody. It brings the town together.
Mike Irvin, we are looking and looking. What do you think of it? Thumbs up. There we go.
They're not doing this to make money. They're doing it to put on a show and to get out there and have a good time.
You don't get to see something like this every day, I guess.
small towns have one thing in common. They all come together to put on something for everyone to enjoy. Many of these events wouldn't be possible without the support they receive from their communities. These towns may be small, but they have heart. When attending these events, you feel welcomed into their big family, and like a funny uncle or cousin, they put on a pretty good show.
Being dirty.